And so, you know, in the early days of crypto, you know, the word on the street was always this exchange got hacked, that exchange got hacked. But of course, since crypto is dominated by the best engineers and minds in the world that have gravitated toward this space, the incidence of these hacks has been reduced dramatically. Meanwhile, in the legacy banking system, not so much protection against hacks. So there's been a major hack of Mexican banks. Tell us about it. How does it impact your business, if at all?
Yes, there have been some delays in transfers. There were some rumors that banking system got hacked, that banks got hacked. There isn't much information flowing, but now there is some information that they were actually able to create this phony accounts and transfer money out of the banks. And how it has been impacted is that there's a contingency in the banking system, and there's delays in transfers. So, for example, there's a lot of users that withdraw money from Bitso or deposit into Bitso, and normally we did a great integration in which this is an instant transaction, and right now it's taking hours. And it's not only us, it's the whole banking system, because they're in contingency. They're flowing very slowly, and they're trying to find out what has happened, and they're doing the investigations internal.
Yeah, it's funny. I mean, in the banking system, the number of hours and days it takes to clear trades could be 3 days, could be a normal clearing time. And if there's a problem, the system works so slowly that they many times can fix these problems before it's noticed, because the whole thing kind of goes slowly. But with crypto on the scene, and as you point out, instant transactions, instant confirmations, when the legacy banking system slows up for any particular reason, it shows up quickly. People are aware there is a problem. So this is an interesting checks and balance. I understand actually in Mexico now, they're bringing on another exchange to compete with the current exchange. It's been around for 100 years. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, we only had one stock exchange in Mexico, which is called the Bolsa Mexicana de Valores. So
so that's really interesting information. And once again, you don't really see this stuff in mainstream media. When they're covering crypto, they never talk about how banks get hacked, and that, you know, it's common, and you're not going to see that in the news. But just because they're traditional banks doesn't mean that they're not going to get hacked from time to time. And just for me, myself, personally, I've dealt with plenty of bank fraud transactions. They're very long. They're very annoying. Fortunately, I got all my money back. And for now, knock on wood, crypto's been good to me. I haven't had any issues with crypto. But, you know, I do a very good job of playing the role of Blackbeard, like a pirate. I don't have more than 5,000 on any one account or exchange. I have a bunch of different passwords, and do a pretty good job of just protecting myself. So I've been blessed on that part. But at the same time, like I said, it's just really interesting that, you know, there's plenty of banks that have to deal with these kind of issues. But when you're watching at least the U.S. media, when they talk about crypto, there's always a lot of publicity about, you know, hacks and people not getting their money. So just interesting to see the counter argument. Let me know what you guys think about this, and I will talk to you soon.